just want a quick look, that's all.
I've told you, it's fine.
You're wasting your breath.
I do have a qualification in first aid.
Well, I don't have a qualification in anything. But I do know that once your daughter's made up her mind to do something, she won't change it.
Yeah, she always was a stubborn child.
Wonder who I got that from.
I'll be off soon.
Say hi to everyone for me, won't you?
What's this meeting about again?
Farmers Unite.
Oh, working out the best way to spend the latest subsidy.
You what?
Jim.
Have you any idea what I've been going through the past few years? We're on our knees here.
Look, I was simply trying to point out...
Well, don't! You just stick to your precious plays. Some of us have got proper work to do. I shouldn't be too late. Keep an eye on that cow.
Esmeralda?
Yeah, whatever. She's well overdue.
Will do.
Was it something I said?
Your taxi's waiting.
I know. Look, are you sure you're going to be all right?
We'll be fine. Bath time in half an hour, then a quick tuck in, and he'll be well away by seven. Mm. And I can watch the footy.
Yeah, well, thanks for doing this. You know what, with Mac and his charity dinner and everything.
It's not a problem. Now go. Say bye.
Bye.
Why doesn't he like you giving the cows names?
You know, Jim. He takes good care of his cattle, but to him they're just numbers on a balance sheet. Red numbers at the moment.
I don't know how you can stand the smell.
You get used to it. You don't have to stay, you know, Dad.
I know. Just don't often have a chance to see my only daughter.
Whose fault's that? You're always welcome here.
I'm not sure Jim feels the same.
I do wish you'd try and get on with him.
I have. I do.
Things have been very tough recently.
Yes, they have at the university. The department's getting another funding cut this year.
It's hardly the same.
We'd be nothing without culture.
We'd be nothing without food on the table.
I know. I've just never understood why you felt you had to be one of the people who put it there. You had a very promising career as an actress.
Poncing around in silly clothes, wearing too much makeup. It wasn't real, Dad.
And this is? Ripping your arm open on a barbed wire fence? Slopping around in a yard full of freezing manure? If this is real, you can keep it. I'm phoning the doctor.
No, it's all right. Why do you have to dramatise everything?
Very nice. Well, apart from the hair.
Yes, I know. Can't do a thing with it.
Come here.
Have you thought any more about what we talked about?
Not our own practice.
Uh-huh.
Thought of nothing else.
And? Oh, come on, Helen. You know we make a great team.
Oh, excuse me.
It's all right. Hairdressing services.
Ah. Oh, missed a bit. There. Very dashing. You shall go to the ball.
Right. Thank you.
What are you doing tonight?
Nothing. Mustn't be up too late, though. Got an early start.
Well, Phil's taking the kids up to his parents. How do you fancy a meal and a good girly chat?
Oh, when don't I?
Got an experimental dance troupe coming to the Studio Theatre next week. The Aaron Brown Ensemble from New York.
I'll be mucking out the cowshed.
Ah.
Sometimes I wonder whether we actually inhabit the same planet. Even after Mum died, I always got the impression you were happier at work than you were doing things with me.
That is not fair. I had to keep working for the money.
Other people's dads worked too. They also spent time with their daughters.
If you'd carried on as an actress, that was an interest we could share.
That was your interest, Dad, not mine. When have you ever wanted to share one of mine? Cup of tea?
Yeah, I'll go.
I can manage.
Let me see. I'm calling the doctor.
Yeah, I think you better had.
Well, I'm sure she won't be a minute. Do you want me to call you a taxi?
No, thanks, I've got one coming.
I'm sorry I'm late. Oh, you look nice.
Thank you. Yeah.
Come on then, give us a twirl.
Oh. Very nice.
Very nice. You look stunning, Kate.
Oh, I must get a picture. Stand together.
Oh, don't you make a lovely couple?
Yes.
Hello, Riverside.
Ready to go?
Oh, well, it's early yet. We could get a drink.
Right. Anyone else? Mac?
Well, you've got that dinner to go to.
No, I've got time for a quick orange juice.
Excuse me, Mark. It's about Cordelia Watt, Wilbury Farm. She needs a home visit. She's having some problems with her stitches.
Oh.
Sorry, I've got a pile of paperwork to get through.
I'm having dinner.
Where's Jude?
With Jude.
Well, Matt can do it.
Will I?
Oh, you're the only one available.
Oh, well, I will then. Look at her notes, will you? And tell her I'll be there as quickly as I can.
Thanks, Mac. I know you're busy too.
No problem. Kate could do with a good night out.
Hi. How was your course?
Better than your courtesy car.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with it. Anyway, it'll be dark soon. Are you around later?
Yeah, can we talk in a minute? I need to have a quick word of faith.
Well, are we ready to go?
Yes, of course.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Why didn't you tell me about Liam?
What? Who told you?
Mark told me.
He had no right.
But why did you tell him and not me?
I needed to tell someone.
But why not me?
You weren't there. Mark was. Oh, he shouldn't have told you.
You've got to go to the police.
No, it's over.
Faith, you were raped. You can't put it aside like it didn't happen.
Yes, I can.
So you were raped.
I don't want to talk about this, all right? Least of all to you.
I'll see you later.
What's going on?
Nothing. It's sorted, really.
Okay. Have you got any suture packs, please?
Everything okay?
No, not really.
Would you fancy a drink? You can tell me all about it.
Yeah, a bit later. There's something I need to sort out first.
Okay. Well, that suits me. I've got a ton of paperwork to catch up on.
Right. About 8.
Mm. Are you sure you won't have another?
No, thank you. I want to keep a clear head.
This is fun, isn't it?
It is.
I haven't had a glam night out since, oh, I don't know how long. I mean, they were never really Max Forte. And what with Kieran, well...
You should make the most of it, then.
I fully intend to, don't worry.
When did you have this done?
Day before yesterday, at St. Phil's.
Did they recommend humping great bales of hair around as part of your rehab?
No.
No.
You tell her, Doctor. She won't listen to me.
Can't help but listen to you, because he never stopped talking.
Then why don't you take any notice of me?
Because I'm still waiting for you to say something interesting.
There does seem to be some infection. I'll give you something for that. A mild antibiotic. The wound needs cleaning, and you're going to need a couple more stitches.
Can you do that now?
Well, I should send you back to St. Phil's by Ryan.
Please, Doctor. It really hurts. I'd be ever so grateful.
Well, it does so happen that I have the right equipment with me, so...
Problem, Dad?
Oh, I'll just go and get the stuff.
Cordelia.
Cordelia, right.
Are you familiar with Shakespeare, Doctor? King Lear?
No, not really.
How sharper than a serpent's tooth it is to have a thankless child.
I'll just get the stuff.
Go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep, little Kieran, 'cause I want to watch the football. Behave yourself.
Let me in.
Well, I've just got Kieran off to sleep.
Oh, yeah? And how are you sleeping, you scumbag, after what you did to Faith?
You what? Well, what did I do?
You raped her.
That's nonsense.
Well, that's not what she's saying.
Well, she's a liar.
I wouldn't be standing here having a conversation with you if you weren't the boss's son. You'd be talking to the police.
Oh, you're going to report me, are you? Odd that Faith hasn't done that, don't you think?
No one knew out of Netherbridge.
Ah, I know what's going on here. You've decided she's not good enough for you, but you can't bear to let anyone else have her. Really, Ben, that's no way to treat a lady, is it?
God, you creep!
You've woken the baby.
You never were very good at the realities of life, were you?
I just don't like to see you in pain, that's all. Should it be making that noise?
No. Go and see what the matter is. I'll deal with it as soon as I can. Sorry, we're always like this. My father's always been a great talker, but he's not so hot on the practical side.
But you are?
Yes. Got that from Mum. Jim, that's my husband, says me and my dad are more like a couple sometimes the way we bicker.
Any brothers and sisters?
No, just me. I looked after Dad, really, when I was growing up. He's useless. Can't even change a light bulb.
You used to be an actress, didn't you?
Yes. It's what Dad wanted. He runs the drama department down at the university.
Mm-hmm.
He's always been an academic rather than a performer. I think he wanted me to play out his unfulfilled ambitions.
But you didn't fancy that?
No.
Not easy being a parent, you know? I mean, you watch your kids growing up, hoping they won't make the same mistakes that you did. Then they go ahead and make completely different ones. Oh, and some of the same. Sorry.
It'd be easier if we hadn't been having such a hard time recently. We lost our entire herd with foot and mouth last year. We're just starting to build things up again. So, how many children do you have?
Three boys and a girl.
And what do you think makes a good father?
Well, I think you should ask my kids that.
They're not here.
I don't know. Understanding, tolerance, a full wallet.
There's something not right about that cow.
Who said chivalry wasn't dead?
Shall we go in?
Yes.
I think the calf's front legs are back.
What?
The calf's legs are stuck in the womb. It can't come out, can't go back in again. We need to get it out as soon as we can, or we could lose them both.
How do we do that?
We phone the vet.
Oh. There you go. Oh.
And I'll have the beef, please.
I didn't think you were a red meat person.
Well, not normally. Just feel like ringing a few changes, that's all.
Oh, yeah?
You know the feeling, stuck in a rut. Time for a new outfit, a new hairdo. It's working wonders for Kate.
With me, it's normally a new husband.
I think that's going a bit far. I'm quite happy with the one I've got, thank you.
No dice, I'm afraid. Can't be here for at least 2 hours.
Can't we just pop it back in till he comes?
No. The umbilical cord's probably separated. It'd suffocate. But if it stays in there much longer, it'll start thrashing around. It could do all sorts of damage to the lining of the womb. Damage, just one thing after another.
Well, there must be something you can do.
There is. If we can reach inside the womb and bend the calf's legs into the right position, we should be able to attach a rope and pull it out, no problem. I've done it before, a couple of times.
Not with your arm in a sling.
I've no choice. We're on a knife edge at the moment. Can't afford to lose two healthy animals.
No, it's out of the question. You've got fresh stitches and an infected wound.
Then you'll have to do it.
Me?
Yes, you deliver babies.
Well, it's hardly the same, is it?
Yes, it is. Only on a larger scale.
And with a rope.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I understand the situation you're in, but...
I'm asking you,
As a father?
What?
Well, that's what traditionally happens, isn't it? When a daughter's got a tricky problem, errant boyfriend, dodgy car, asks her father.
Dad, you were too squeamish to be present at my birth. It's hardly your thing, is it?
Not really, no. But I am your father.
I just feel like I'm letting the grass grow under my feet. Take Mark, for instance. His energy, his drive, his vision, he leaves me breathless sometimes.
He's just ambitious, that's all. I'm sure you were like that once.
That's exactly my point. And now I'm stuck in a rut.
A rut? great husband, two smashing kids, a senior partner of a flourishing medical practice. You've made it, Helen. Big time. I mean, what else could you possibly need?
I don't know. A challenge?
And what did you have in mind? Climbing the Matterhorn? Winning the World Cup single-handed?
Well...
What?
Oh, nothing, just something Mark and I were talking about.
There you go, talking about Mark again. You sure he isn't the challenge you've got in mind?
No, of course not. I'm a happily married woman.
Of course. Ray is quite attractive, don't you think?
I haven't really noticed. Why, are you interested?
No. Well, there is something about him. Can't quite put my finger on it. He's trouble, that one.
Unlike you.
You could still make the golf club dinner.
No, it's fine. Might be of some help. Somehow.
Ready?
I wish I had my camera.
Okay.
Ow! You okay?
Yeah, she squeezed my arm.
Ah, contractions, I expect.
Are you past the head?
Yeah, I think I'm near the front shoulder. Do cows have shoulders?
Certainly do.
Now, move your hand down and follow the line of the leg.
Well, it is a bit of a stretch. Yep. Ow!
Oh, are you okay?
I think she bit me.
Oh, you'll be all right.
Can't say the same for your trousers.
Poor little thing. I'm going back in. There we go. Yes. Oh, okay, it's all right. Shoulder.
Follow the line of the leg till you reach the knee.
Yeah, it's coming.
You should be able to bend the lower half of the leg round. And slip the rope over the leg, not round the ankle, but about halfway back up towards the knee.
Yeah, it's all right, sweetheart. It's all right. Got it.
Great. Now, pull the rope gently back out again.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Are you sure you've never done that before?
Never.
Right. And now for the other one.
Hi, it's me. It's 25 to 9. I'll give you 10 more minutes and then I'm off home. Bye.
Easy does it. Esmeralda's doing most of the work. She just needs a bit of help, that's all.
She must be exhausted.
She's not the only one.
Here we go.
Ah!
Let me see.
All right. Is it all right?
Check its airway.
I don't think it's breathing.
Dad, quick, poke its nostril with a bit of straw.
This?
Yeah. Well, you can hardly go smacking it on the bottom, can you?
Great.
Sure you can't stay any longer?
Get thee behind me, Thompson. No, I've already seriously compromised a quiet evening in and an early night. Besides, we'll be back soon.
Not for a couple of hours.
I bet you can't wait to see him and your gorgeous kids.
No.
You don't sound too enthusiastic.
No, of course I am. I was just thinking, that's all.
I tell you what, if you're stuck in a rut, from where I'm standing, it's a pretty nice rut to be in. I'll see you in the morning.
Okay? Bye.
Well done, baby. Doing fine, I'd say.
That trick with the straw was magic.
It wasn't magic, Dad. It was good animal husbandry. That's one of my interests. Thanks for sharing it with me.
Yes. I'd love to know more about what goes on in the new primary care trust.
Mark! Hello, Matthew.
Maybe later? Thank you.
That was Matthew Hill. He's the vice chair of the new primary care trust.
Yes, we were just chatting.
You've got all the time in the world to chat. Tonight, you've got to dance with me and me alone. Sorry, I'm a bit tiddly.
Do you think we should be making a move soon?
But it's still early yet.
I think the fresh air will be good for you.
Are you trying to get me on my own?
I'll get my coat.
Sorry, I got a wee bit drunk.
No, it's okay.
Had a lovely evening, though.
So did I.
But the night is yet young. I'm sorry, that's a silly thing to say. I can't invite you in. I could, but Liam's at home and three's a crowd and all that.
No, it's okay.
Look at your bow tie. Yeah, that's better. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought.
Okay, it's okay. It's okay.
I better go.
Kate.
It's okay. Just don't go home. Just go.
Okay. Had a good evening.
Thanks again, Doctor.
I didn't do anything. I hope the calf's okay.
He'll be fine. Mm-hmm. What's your first name?
Brendan.
Ever had an animal named after you before?
Well, no, not that I'm aware of.
You have now.
Oh, right. Look, shouldn't you name it after your dad? He did all the work.
She already has. There's a donkey in the next field called Edgar. Rather a stubborn beast, I recall.
Sorry, Dad.
That's all right, Cordy. You've probably got a point. Brendan it is, then.
Oh, that's great. I'll come and visit.
Make it quick, then. You'll be off to market in a couple of weeks.
Ah.
But come and visit anyway, if ever the office politics get intolerable.
I might just do that. Bye.
Come on, Dad, let's get back inside.
What do you mean that about the market?
Real life, Dad, remember? You always did like veal, didn't you?
I think I'll go and check on Brendan.
Ben? Phil, you made me jump.
Sorry, I was looking for Helen.
Problem?
Yeah, well, car's broken down just round the corner. Saw the light was on, thought Helen might be working late.
Well, I think she's having dinner with Jude.
Oh, right. Yeah, well, her phone was switched off.
Well, I'm going home. Do you want me to give you a lift?
Yeah? Well, that'd be great. It's way past the kids' bedtime. I can pick the car up in the morning.
Yeah. Come on, then. All aboard.
Mind if I come in?
No, please.
Sorry. Haven't quite got used to the car yet.
I've been talking with Jude. Not about specifics, but about making changes, not letting the grass grow under my feet.
And?
The new practice. I want to go for it. You're right, we could be great together.
Yes, that's brilliant news. We should celebrate.
I should be getting home.
Oh, do you have to?
After all my hard work.
Time at your parents?
Yeah. I'm just looking forward to getting home now.
What the hell? We'll be right back.